thermal properties of matter. Okay, so we will discuss what is the thermal, what is the matter. So first I'll tell about the thermal. What is the thermal? So in the thermal, especially we can use, there are two words will be there. One is temperature, another one is heat and radiation. Those things will be exist. Okay, thermal properties of matter. First we'll see matter. Matter. First, what is the matter? Okay. Matter means it occupies space and mass. It has mass and occupies space. Then we can say that is the matter. So myself is here. I am having mass and I am occupying space. Then we can say that is the matter. Okay, next, matter is made of matter. How we can make matter? So the matter is made by the particles. If I consider this chalk piece or this marker, or if I consider blackboard, whatever, if you consider, that is made by the particles. Particles. Okay, the particle arrangement, based on that the matter can be divided into the particle arrangement based on that the matter can be divided into three parts. Sick gas. Based on which property? Particle nature. Particles. So solid is matter, liquid also matter, next gas also matter. Okay. How, why we are calling this is solid, why we are calling this is liquid, why we are calling this is gas? Okay, in what sense? Then based on which principle we are calling this is solid, based on which principle we are calling this is liquid, based on which principle we are calling solid. Okay, we are going to study in this chapter. So what is the chapter name? Thermal properties of matter. Okay, this what we can say, this is the introduction. Introduction. So now we'll see the solid. Okay, in the solid or liquid or gas, every state the contain its particles or molecules or atoms. Okay, how the particle arrangement will be there in this? Inside the solid, the particle arrangement will be very tightly bounded. This is a solid, this is a liquid, that is the gas. Okay, here particles, how arranged here? Very nearly arranged, very tightly bounded. So here particles, okay, compared to this, a little bit gap is there in between the particles. Here gas, the particles, very long distance will be there. So why I said about the solid, liquid, gas in this lesson means, see, what is the thermal properties of matter? So in the day-to-day life, thermal means we can discuss the relevant two words we can discuss. One is temperature, another one is heat. First letter we can discuss. First word is heat, another one is temperature. These two words are very, very important. So let us take suppose on very, very hot day, you are outside. Okay, what happens automatically? Your body will also get heat. Okay, how, why your body gets heat? Or else the water is there in the container outside. The sunlight is coming and falling on that water. Then what happens? Water automatically heat. After some time, what happens? The water will be, suppose more temperature is there. Then what happens? Water will evaporate. Like that, the process will be going on. Okay, suppose if you keep something outside, if sunlight is there, automatically that it's getting heat. Or if you touch, that is sometime if you touch the, if sun is not there, if you touch the, you can feel warm. Suppose the sun is there, you can feel hot. Like that you can observe. So what is the heat and what is the temperature we are going to study? Okay, suppose some iron rod is there. Okay, if iron rod is there, if you heat, what happen that if you keep iron rod in the fire, what happen? The iron rod will be heat. Why? What happen? The fire and iron, what is happening? The how the iron rod will gets heat? Next, or else if you take milk, if you take boiling milk, so if you want to drink the milk, first we have to boil. So you will drink very hot milk or normal milk or room temperature milk. Okay, no one can drink the hot milk. So what we have to do, simply we have to keep in the atmosphere. Then what happen after some time, the milk will come normal temperature, then we are able to drink. Suppose sometime we need so hot water is there, we are unable to drink. So the in that case, what happen, we have to keep that water in the fridge. What happen in that case, sometime we need cool water, sometime we need hot water. So in the both cases, why, what all things is happening? So if you keep hot, it is coming to low temperature, sometime it is going to high temperature, rising temperature, lowing temperature, it is more, what all things is happening. Okay, how we are measuring it. Okay, how we are measuring temperature. Okay, the surroundings we are having. Okay, suppose we are inside, if you close the room and there is if you close door and windows, if you are inside, if you will be inside, there is no fan, nothing. If you are inside, what happen your body? Next to the, if you open all those things, then what happen your body? Then comparison will be there, you and surrenders, or our environmental and surrenders. Okay, the temperature will going from one place to another place. Okay, in which form it is going from one place to another place, or it is going from one place to another place. Sometime we may lost heat also, sometime we may gain heat also, sometime it is required, sometime it is not required. Okay, how these things are happening? So nowadays, see, we are observing our earth is daily the way it is observing more. Why? Because we are very aware, we should awareness of this. Nowadays we are getting the global warming due to that, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, due to that ozone layers, many unnecessary gases are revolving, digging the earth. Due to that, what happened? There are heat is generating. Due to that, what happened? The global warming happened. Due to the global warming, what happened? The plants are destroying. So the animals also get animals also affected. We are also getting different types of diseases. Okay, why all those things happening? Means this is the radiation also, we can say one sense. So the radiation, how the heat is traveling from one place to, so from, if you want to get the heat, suppose if you want to get light, what do you, from where we can get? From the sun we can get the light. Okay, light is traveling from sun to the earth in the form of rays. So sun rays are falling at one place continuously, then what happened, that place will be the place where the sun rays are falling, that area will be automatically rise the temperature. So first it will get some objects will be heat absorb, some objects will be heat may not absorb. So depend upon that we can discuss all those things. Okay, how we are measuring the heat, how we are measuring the temperature, all those things we can discuss in the chapters. Okay, this is a small introduction about the thermal properties and matter. Next one, we'll discuss very important words are there, those words, temperature and heat. Next word, next one we can discuss about the heat and temperature. Next, we can based on the thermal properties only we can tell about the temperature and heat. Okay, first we'll see the what is the temperature and what is the heat. We'll see. So the heat, if you want to know about, suppose how much heat is there, suppose if you want to boil the water, okay, as soon as keep on the stove, what happen, the water will heat? No, it won't heat water. Okay, after certain time the water will absorbs, the water will absorb some energy from the fire, then what happen, water will gets heat. Then so again, if you are giving fire continuously, then what happen, automatically the water will absorb more energy. Then what happens automatically, the water temperature will be increasing. So here what happened, the energy, the nothing but what we can say, definition here, see, heat. What is the heat? Heat means it is a form of energy. Okay, it is a form of energy. Okay, it can flow from lower level to higher level. So where we can say, let us take, we are having the cool water in the winter season. What you are having, everyone wants to take bath in the winter season. The cool water will be there, or chilly water will be there. So what happened, will you do bath with chilly water? Not possible to do chilly water bath. Okay, in that case, what we have to do, simply we have to heat the water. So heat the water, then we can take bath nicely. Okay, how much extent you can heat? Okay, certain extents we need, from 50 degree centigrade or 40 degree centigrade or 25 degree centigrade, up to that much we can heat and we can take the bath nicely. So what is the definition of heat? Heat is a form of energy. It is traveling from one place to another place, or it is traveling from lower to higher. Next one, temperature. Okay. So temperature, how we can define the temperature? The temperature is denoted by the T. Okay, the heat is measuring, the there will be measurements will be there. Heat is measured with calorimeter. Then next, temperature is measurement thermometer. So how we are measuring the heat? Calorimeter. Next, then temperature, how we are measuring with temperature? We can measure, there are instruments will be there, that I will tell how we are measuring the temperature. So what is the definition of temperature? So if you know about the heat, then we can define the temperature. How much hotness the body, how much hotness, the degree of hotness or coldness, we can call that is the temperature. Temperature. What is the definition of temperature? The degree of hotness or coldness of body is called temperature. Okay, temperature, there are the different types of measurements will be there, though we will discuss. Now you understood, no? The difference between heat and temperature. Okay, at last I will tell what is the temperature, what is the heat. There are differences will be there, we'll discuss. Okay, the heat is a form of energy.